So when we launched in 1989, the one untested, untried element of everything was how it would be at retail. What would that retail experience be like? One of the coolest, proudest moments was that first few weeks, first few months of actually being live at retail and watching those Infinity retailers just simply knock it out of the park. In the first J.D. Power CSI survey that we were eligible, we tied first. And in many ways, people were calling that our first report card. We had a lot of theories, we had a lot of great ideas, or ideas we thought were great, and we had a lot of philosophies, but were they right? Was this gonna resonate with actual consumers? They did. The main reasons the retailers were equipped to deliver the experience that they did at retail was the time we took with them at the launch training in Arizona that we did for every person who worked at Infinity. Didn't matter if your job was washing cars or you owned the dealership, you went through the same training. Because that gave us an opportunity to model the behaviors we were asking them to exhibit, to treat them as honored guests, so that they would see what that felt like, so that they could then go treat their employees and their customers and their coworkers as honored guests. The culture, the climate, the ethos of an organization stems from the top leadership. When you have a guy like, had a guy like Bill Bruce, who exhibited that care for other people, the treating everyone as an honored guest, he had a way of making you feel like the most important person in the world. Behind the scenes at Infinity, there was the book or the binder, depending on who you talked to, each tab or chapter of it, if you will, were documents that related to how are we going to operate in sales? How are we going to operate in service? How are we going to operate in parts, philosophically and tactically as well? It wasn't so prescriptive that the retailers were boxed in. We set the guidelines, then let the dealers use their creativity, their genius, to really deliver on that philosophy in a way that was unique to them, unique to their staff, people, and their market. This idea of under-promise and over-deliver. Under-promise just meant let your actions, your delivery, do the talking. Set an expectation and then over-deliver. What's that extra thing that we could do for the person in the next cube or the person in the dealership? How would we take the principle and take it to the next level? Because if you do that, there's no end. You never get there. Just like the badge and the logo, it disappears into infinity, but you know it keeps going. What was interesting about the early advertising, beginning with rocks and trees and geese and ponds, was the through line of everything was getting people engaged in thinking about what they were buying. These ads, the communications were very evocative. One of the very positive side effects of having advertising and marketing that didn't feature the car was there was probably more of a built-in curiosity about what is this Infinity thing all about. I think people came in more curious, which played right into equipping the people that worked at the retailers to tell the story. One of the lessons learned from those early days about the total ownership experience, about creating a memorable, positive experience for customers, is to put them at the center and then pay off on those emotional needs and building that rapport with whatever products or services we offer. The dealership layout was unusual. Infinity was, I believe, the first to ever have a designated position called greeter, with a workstation right at the front door. And this was all built into the architecture of the dealership. They would see a greeter at a desk who would greet them, offer them some hospitality, refreshments, sort of determine why they were there. Because remember, there were no salespeople camped out at desks waiting for the next person to pounce on. It was an empty showroom except for the vehicles, perhaps other customers or guests. So once people got past that point and transitioned into the showroom itself, that was laid out very differently. At the time, typical showroom was like an indoor parking lot. Car, 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 surrounded by desks. Infinity was cordoned off into viewing areas with shoji screens, which are those sort of translucent Japanese folding screens. And in the center was a sculpture, and this was called the contemplation area. Come on, really? In a car dealership? So it was a very, very different experience when you walked in. There was nice furniture to sit on so you could view the vehicle. When you did want help, when you did want a sales consultant to come in and work with you or ask questions, they were summoned from the back and came out to where you were and never sat on the other side of a desk from you. There was this feeling that we were in this together and we were learning about and discovering Infinity together.